Well, good afternoon. I'm Pavel Kaba, director of YASA. I would like to say first thanks to Chatham House. I'm privileged to be here second time in 4 months, first on water in July and second time on energy. Welcome on behalf of YASA. For those who do not know YASA, let me say a few words about what it is and what it's going to be. Maybe that's more important. YASA is an institute which was a product of the Cold War. It was after the assassination of President Kennedy, where Lyndon Johnson became President of the United States and who took initiative to approach the Soviets about the idea to build a bridge between divided worlds through science. And that idea culminated here in London in 72 by signing a YASA Act by 12 countries from all over the world to start an institute which will put together, as is put in the discussion notes, best brains from both worlds to address the issues of major interest. At that time already energy was articulated, but also food, water, through a system analysis, which in YASA case means not only methodologically, mathematically driven approach, but also combination of different disciplines, social sciences, mathematics, statistics, evolution, ecology, what have you. At present, YASA is composed from 20 member countries. Of course, the mission changed. It changed after the wall went down, and I mean, of course, YASA could have stopped because the mission was accomplished. I mean, of course, not by YASA, but by many others. But it was not stopping. It actually got reconfirmed in its mission to global mission. And currently, we have in our council, this is the composition of the countries, all the major BRIC countries, major economies. YASA is growing very much in Asia, for example. And YASA is on its mission to do the studies which are comparable to what we discussed today. Studies which are not only about the sectoral portfolios, energy, studies which are reaching out to the co-benefit synergies. In case of energy assessment, it is to air quality and to the climate. We are starting similar for very soon on water, water futures, and we will be also doing studies which are more related to the interactions between the economic transitions in the world and all the other major challenges. Let me again welcome you this afternoon here to discuss this major study, which I think is the most comprehensive assessment of the energy ever. YASA was, of course, proud to be able to coordinate it. There are more than 300 authors involved in it and many institutions, so it's not a YASA product only, it's a community product. And I hope you enjoy the discussions, presentations here. Let me also tell you that, of course, as a YASA director, I should not stop here and tell you, when we talk about YASA's success in terms of representing the world, you may be noticing that it's remarkable enough that UK is not a member of YASA at this moment. UK was the member of YASA, UK was the founding member of YASA. So we hope very much that this type of discussions, like today Chatham House here, and many others to come, the community of researchers involved in YASA, because I did some statistics, we have more than 50 people from UK involved in YASA projects, would eventually lead to a change, which I would like very much to see during my term, next 3 up to 6 years, that at some point we will celebrate here at this place, the Chatham House, UK membership of YASA again. Thank you very much.